And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. We're going to be treated to a gorgeous day for baseball on the show. It's the New York Mets and the Chicago Cubs.
Ladies and gentlemen.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started
Chicago
after this.
Go.
So just about set, and stepping in is the speedy Brandon Nimmo. The pitch.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
The punch out there, one out in the top of the first. Starling Marte up to hit.
The right fielder, number six.
The 1-1.
Starling Marte.
That's outside. Nice warm day here, good baseball weather. Does that change anything, Chris, especially for the hitters?
Absolutely. You feel so much more comfortable at the plate. You're not worried about, you know, getting jammed on fastballs inside part of the plate. You can kind of be more selective instead of just looking out away so that you can get the barrel to it in that part. You can get on the inside part of the plate as well.
Man at second with one away. Now up to hit Francisco Lindor. Strike two. Got him looking. And two away now. Here's Pete Alonso. This guy has turned into a beast.
Alonso.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That ends the frame. Bottom of the first. So up now for Chicago, Nico Hoerner. 2 balls and a strike. Here comes. That misses off the outside edge. And the 3-1. And there's ball four. Seiya Suzuki, the next Cub to hit.
The right fielder, Seiya Suzuki.
Next offering is in for a strike. A 1-2. Just off the inside edge.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And the pitch. And a swing and a miss. One away. Ian Happ up to hit.
The left fielder, Ian.
And here it comes. That's outside. Ball two. Next offering upstairs. Chris, with that distraction and a speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count. Hoerner on the go. Base knock center field. The throw is wild and it gets away. Ball comes home and he's dead at the plate. Patrick Wisdom, the next Cub to hit.
Third baseman, Patrick.
2 outs.
Wisdom.
A foul ball, he stays alive. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Inning over. Here at Wrigley Field, now it's the DH, Jeff McNeil. The 1-1. To the right side. He takes it on his own. One up, one down. Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to it.
The third baseman, Eduardo Escobar.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. Pat makes the grab, and there's two away.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You've got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. And that should be extra bases. Now he turns and heads for second. And he starts his afternoon off right with a double.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count.
Put a pretty good jolt into that one. Great swing, nice balance and weight transfer. And he got it to drop in out there in the deep part of the field.
Here's Luis Guillorme out towards left center. Pulls up and it drops for a hit. And they'll score first. It's 1-0.
Picks himself up at RBI. When you flare a ball out behind second base, it's really a tough spot for anyone to get to. And you're never trying to do that as a hitter, but when you do, I tell you what, you're yelling at it the entire way to get down.
Next offering in the dirt, and it's 2-1. That one missed. In for a strike. Now it's 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Guillorme off of first with two away. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. Just kind of sliced that one into center. They stopped the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
Now back.
Here's Brandon Nimmo. Next offering is in for a strike. On the ground to third. They get the force. Inning over, and it could have been worse. Back here at Wrigley Field, bottom of the second. Now the Cubs catcher, Wilson Contreras. Going to count 1-2. The pitch. And he chases that one. And there's one down. Now it's Andrelton Simmons. One down, base is empty. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. The next pitch misses. It's 2-2. That's the third. Whips it to first. Already two out here in the home half of inning number two. Here's David Bote. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And that is the third out of the inning. Back here at the friendly confines, here's Starling Marte. Kicks and fires. They say it went. It's a 1-2. On a line, base hit.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. Rolled to short, possible two ball. Off-balance feed, there's one. How about that double play? Two outs, base is empty. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. 0-for-1, he struck out swinging last time. The wind of the pitch. Line the other way. That's a fair ball and down the right field line and towards that corner. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. In there. Just beat the tag. It's a double. And now here's Jeff McNeil. Good contact guy, good defender. Pulled hard, but it's a foul ball. One and two now. Out to short. Horner over to pick it up. Slings it across. Third out, and that ends the frame. Welcome back. Set for the bottom of the third. And here's the rookie center fielder, Nelson Velasquez. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Swing and a tapper. Not in time to get him, and the tapper turns into an infield single.
Batting ninth,
Alfonso Rivas, the next Cub to hit. Next offering is in for a strike. Left-hand batter waits. Stays alive.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base. Try to stay out of a double play here.
Started to go after it. Now we'll look down to third. And he couldn't hold back. He's rung up on strikes. Back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Here's Nico Horner. Next pitch, not close, up high. Velasquez, the base runner at first with one out. Next offering clips the zone, count even at two. Here comes a pitch. Line and a base hit into right. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
Well, that may end up being an at-bat we go back to later on when this game is over. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Marte makes the play, and there are two outs.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at-bat.
Fought off foul. Here's a 1-2.
That's it. Ball two.
And that one is lifted in the air. Dives, but it's off his glove. Pulls him to third safely as a run scores on the play, and that ties the game. So two outs with runners on the corners. Patrick Wisdom, the next Cub to hit. Next offering is in for a strike. Two on, two outs. Next offering is outside. Corners are occupied with two down. The pitch. And now the count filled up 3-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Payoff pitch. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Huge strikeout there. Back here at the ballpark. Onto the fourth. And stepping in for New York, Eduardo Escobar. And the right-hander deals. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
All over that one right there. Wasn't able to elevate that one, but he sure hit it hard enough to get through the infield. There's not a whole lot of time for the defenders to react and try to make a play when it's ripped like that.
Here's Mark Canna. Hard hit right side. And it finds its way through for a hit. Lead runner holds up, They're at first and second with nobody out.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. Just a simple ground ball the other way. They've had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
And here is Luis Guillorme. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Grounder might be two. Bodie over to second, and they get him easily at first. It's a double play. James McCann in now.
Now back. James McCann.
Lace down the line, and now maybe extra bases. In comes the runner from third. It's 2-1. Pulls into second. That's an RBI double.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. When you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. Put a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't fooled at all.
Now it's going to be Brandon Nimmo. And a 2-1 on the way. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. Right past his coach, headed for the plate. The throw in, it's offline, and he scores. And they lead by two.
Back-to-back base hits. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
And now Starling Marte. And another ball. Three-one is on the way. That one the other way. In plenty of time to first. Marte retired. That's the third out. And welcome back. Bottom four. So up now for Chicago, Wilson Contreras. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth. Now it's Andrelton Simmons.
The designated hitter, Andrelton Simmons.
Payoff pitch. Now fly ball to right center. Marte settles underneath it. And there's two down. Here's the second baseman, David Bodie. Went down
13.
On strikes his first
second
time
baseman,
through.
David Bodie.
And a pitch. And a count 1-2. Rolled over to third. Escobar picks it up. Fires across the diamond. Gets him easily. Ends the inning. Here at Wrigley Field, we go to the top of the fifth. Stepping in is the switch hitting shortstop, Francisco Lindor. Here's a 1-1. And that one just missed off the outside edge.
Well, the good thing so far is that he hasn't issued any free passes. Unfortunately, they're making pretty good contact. So not getting the swings and misses and making that defense work behind him. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
And now the first baseman, Pete Alonso. The 2-1. And fouled off. Runner at first with no outs here. Roll to short, could be two. Horner to second, relay to first, double play. Two outs, base is empty. Jeff McNeil stands in.
Designated hitter, Jeff McNeil.
On the ground, right side. To first, and that is that. Bottom of the inning. Here's the center fielder, Nelson Velasquez. The Y to kick the pitch. And it's filled up. Got him. And one out now. And here's the first baseman, Alfonso Rivas. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Next one misses, 2-1. And a good eye there.
Is there a little wrinkle to that?
I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. And a payoff pitch. Rips one to right, base hit. So the one out hit turns the lineup over.
Solid swing from start to end, on time with everything, really good balance, nice extension, and he met it out front for the line drive knock. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Stepping in, Nico Horner. Tying run at the plate. On the ground right side, and it finds its way through for a hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Back-to-back singles. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
And here is Seiya Suzuki.
One ball.
Next offering is fouled back. Two on, one out. And it's even up.
That's a really good take.
And now the lefty stays alive. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. To short, could be two. To second, there's one. Over to Alonso, double play. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, number 62. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
So at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm. Coming out of the bullpen, we'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back here at Wrigley Field. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. And stepping in for New York, Eduardo Escobar. And a pitch. In the air, out towards right center. Velasquez, long run into the gap. Makes a nice running catch. One down.
Up next,
Mark Canna.
Mark Canna.
The wind of the pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Righty to the plate. Swing and he breaks his bat. On the run, sends it over to first. Out on a bang-bang play, but he made it close. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the second baseman, Luis Guillorme. And 1-2. The pitch. And a swing and a miss, and that'll do it. Trevor Williams gets handed the rock out of the pen.
Now pitching for New York, number 29, Trevor Williams.
Bottom of the sixth inning. Digging in is the switch inning outfielder, Ian Happ. Next pitch misses. 2-2. And the righty deals. And that's ripped into left. Base hit.
Oh, this has been a really nice game at the plate for him. He looks locked in. Textbook bat control right there. Got a pitch on the outside. Saw it deep into the zone and just barreled it up. Went the other way for the knock.
Next offering misses. And that's ball three. And a pitch.
Now these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. Wilson Contreras now up to the plate.
You don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against it.
The next pitch misses, and that's ball two.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
In the air, out towards left center, grabs it on the run. Runner tags up for third. Not in time. He's safe. Two on, one out. Now it'll be the Cubs DH. Andrelton Simmons.
The designated hitter, Andrelton.
The 2-1. And there's the strike.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
The 2-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Next pitch in the dirt. 3-2 now. Kicks and deals. Swing and a ball lifted to center field. That's a base hit. Run scores.
Just a huge at bat right there. These days, most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat, you're thinking it's going to be a pop out, and it just kind of nestled into that spot where no one was able to get to it.
And now David Bodie. Next offering is foul back.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
Got him looking. Now two away. Nelson Velasquez, the next Cub to hit. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
And a count 1-2. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Next one misses, and the count's full. Got him! And he's down on strikes for the second time today. Back here at the friendly confines, here is James McCann. That one misses in the dirt.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
On the ground, right side, and that's just foul. The wind and the pitch. There's a swing and a drive. Dives, but it falls. And now it looks like extra bases. He's in with a double, and that's his second double of the night.
Oh, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there.
I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
And the batter now, Brandon Nimmo.
One ball.
And a ball and two strikes. A little roller up along first. The flip to the pitcher covering. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out. Starling Marte digs in now.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Up the middle. That's a base hit. Run scores. One down. So up next for New York, Francisco Lindor. Here's a 1-1. Good eye right there. The 2-1. Marte of the move. Pitch inside. Tag. Ow! A rocket of a throw from Wilson Contreras. Right-hander kicks, deals. In the air out to center. Velasquez should have this one. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. That is the inning.
7 minutes stretch.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. So up now for Chicago, Alfonso Rivas.
Here we go.
Bounce to the left side. Escobar with the throw to first. And one away in the bottom of the seventh. Back to the top of the lineup. Nico Horner, the next Cub to hit. And that one lifted in the air center field. Nimmo under it. He's got it, and there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. Now the number two hitter, Seiya Suzuki.
Seiya Suzuki.
1-1 now. Now a screamer into the outfield. And the inning is over. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Scott Efros. It's his job to keep his team in the game. Back here at the ballpark, ready to begin the eighth. Here's a big power threat, Pete Alonso. Cut on and miss, struck him out, and one gone. Now here is Jeff McNeil. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. Ripped on a line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down. Two outs. Base is empty. And now it's switch hitting third baseman Eduardo Escobar. And he deals. Off the plate, and it's 2-1. On the ground, right side. Throws to first. Escobar out of the play. Third out. Adam Ottavino getting the call to the mound. He has a great slider with tons of movement.
Adam Ottavino.
Welcome back. Here's the left fielder, Ian Happ. The 1-1. Hit hard on the ground to short. And there's a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dive.
having himself a really nice game at the plate. Everyone's trying to elevate the ball in today's game, but if you can hit a ball that hard on the ground, it's going to find some holes.
Next to hit, Patrick Wisdom. Swing and a miss. 1-2. That's down and in. Two, two down. Bounce to the right side. Lindor, that's one. Over to first, safe. Here's the catcher, Wilson Contreras. This guy has turned 40. Into one of the best catchers in the game, but was originally signed by the Cubs as an infielder. Here's the pitch, runner on the go. Ball misses. McCann fires. Stolen base. Righty delivers. A little bit low. Now this one is hammered way back there. On its way and gone. And we are tied. Wilson Contreras blasts one out. And we have a tie ball game. It's 4-4.
There was a cutter away. Kind of works like a slider. You've got to stay on it, let it travel a little bit, and then get your arms extended. Really good piece of hitting right there.
Andrelton Simmons, the next Cub to hit. 1-3. Ball to strike. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled. Back and forth we go, a seesaw battle in the late stages of this one. This one in the air right field. Marte glides to his left. Pulls it in on the run. And there's two down. Here's the second baseman, David Bodie.
Second baseman, David Bodie.
Right-handed reliever. That one to first. No play, that's an infield single.
Didn't exactly square that one up, but sometimes you don't have to. Now a huge at-bat in this game coming up.
Drew Smith gets the call from the pen, and he has some nasty breaking stuff.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the New York Mets, number 62, Drew Smith.
And next for the Cubs, Nelson Velasquez. The 1-1. Just missed. At the belt and fires.
Your base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Tied at 4. Hammered on the line. Base hit.
Here comes the runner.
The relay. Time. He scores. And it's now 5-4.
Clutch hitting right there to give him the lead this late in the ballgame. Ripped that one down the line and kept it fair. And even when you hit it that far out front, you still have to keep your hands tight to your body so you don't hook around that baseball and put it in foul territory. And that right there was perfect.
Here's a 2-2. Here's the pitch. Runner on the move. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Good job at damage control right there. Welcome back, and here comes the closer, David Robertson. We go to the ninth. Now the left fielder, Mark Canna. Next offering is foul back. The 1-2. Out to short. On the run, throw to first. And the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Left-hand hitter waits. Swings through that one. Crowd locked in right now. One-run game here in the ninth. A bouncer to Bodie. Only one out remaining for the Mets. James McCann up now for the Mets.
Catcher James McCann.
One one to McCann. And now one strike away. Just one strike away. And that's down and away.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
Got him! And that's the ball game.
Well, these guys were able to take the lead in the bottom of the eighth and just cruise to this win, getting those final three outs at the top of the ninth. Excellent job of securing your home field and keeping the fans in the ball game all the way to the end. Nice W all the way around.
Close one here today, and your final 5-4. The Cubs go home a winner. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 5 runs, 12 hits, no errors.